Hey everybody, Dylan here again, and I'm going to answer our RPGaDay 2017 Day 4 question, which is, since August 2016, what game have you been playing the most? For me, that is Battle Century G. Battle Century G is a super robot, mecha, anime, tabletop, tactics role-playing game. That's a lot of words, forgive me. That is actually developed by a one-man team. It's developed by a dude who goes by Gimmick Man. You can find it on DriveThruRPG. I'm going to put the link for that down in the comments. But it's very interesting because it kind of combines a kind of crunchy tactical gameplay that rewards you for making synergistic choices and making a team that kind of works together and has things that build off of each other and kind of using the grid environment to your advantage while also still being an extremely story-oriented game. Every character can generate what are called genre points. This is probably my favorite mechanic in the game. But you start with one or more genre points based on your character's power level, and you actually earn more genre points as you take damage throughout the course of a fight. So each time you lose a chunk of your health at certain thresholds, you gain more genre points so that you become more powerful as the battle goes on, and it meets all those really cool, like, Burning Warrior Spirit anime tropes that I'm super in love with. The other thing I really like about Battle Century G is that you can refluff anything you purchase, whether on the pilot side or the mecha side of your character sheet. So say, for example, you purchase an assault rifle. All the weapons come in these discrete packages that have a name and then an effect list, right? So you pick an assault rifle and it does, you know, it lets you shoot into a melee without hitting your friends, right? I can say for my mecha, which is named Cosmic Blader, and it's all about hitting people with a sword, I can say, okay, I have an assault rifle on my character sheet, but the for it is actually that I swing my sword and a laser beam comes out and it cuts the other guy up at range, and it works exactly the same as the assault rifle mechanically. It just doesn't have to look like it at all. It works the same way on the human side of your character sheet. My character has an item called nanomedical vest that lets him resist getting knocked out. Instead of being an actual equipment item, we fluff it as his alien blood and his burning warrior spirit prevent him from being overcome. Works exactly the same, captures a different trope. It's very flexible. We actually even have some plans to use this to perhaps reflect other genre of anime that aren't mecha oriented. Magical girl stuff and Super Sentai stuff are both kind of on our list of potential adaptations for Battle Century G. Anything in which you have like a human form and then a more powerful combat form, it would be appropriate to use the system for that because it's one of the core kind of premises of the system. But yeah, I really enjoy it. You should check it out. As I said, it's by Gimmick Man. It's on DriveThruRPG. The link will be down in the description. It's available via print on demand on DriveThruRPG. I really recommend it. It's not very expensive. This guy super deserves your money. There's a core book and there's actually a whole supplement book. And let me just remind you that he does this whole thing by himself. He has no other developers. So really check it out if you are even tangentially interested in that sort of thing. And while you're at it, go ahead and tell me what else you're tangentially interested in down in the comments. What have you been playing since August 2016 of last year? Let me know. Remember to hit the subscribe button afterwards. I hate saying that. Share the video. Let people know what's going on. Give me a like. Start a conversation. Let's do this thing. I'll see you guys tomorrow for another question. And until then, take it easy. Bye. See ya.